If you have a long horizontal section, long horizontal well, like this, you will also always have the heel toe effect.
In horizontal wells, we call this end the toe and this end the heel. As fluids flow from the toe towards the heel, on their way to the surface, a significant drop in pressure occurs inside the pipe along the horizontal section. This is what we call the heel-to-toe effect. The pressure drop is caused by the friction created between the fluid and the pipe walls, otherwise known as friction loss, which implies that the fluid loses energy along the way due to frictional forces. That's how the pressure gradually decreases inside the well pipe as the fluid flows from the toe to the heel. Naturally, the longer the horizontal section and the longer the fluid has to travel, the higher the friction loss and the pressure drop is. But while this pressure difference occurs inside the base pipe, note that the outside pressure of the reservoir remains constant. This results in a higher differential pressure between the reservoir and the inside of the base pipe at the heel compared to that at the toe. This is why you will have a higher driving force or pressure drawdown and therefore a higher flow rate at the heel section of a well, which gradually decreases towards the toe section. This also means, regardless of reservoir heterogeneity or fluid viscosity, that the inflow rate of a long horizontal well is naturally imbalanced to begin with.